Hi and welcome to our channel. I'm Jim.
And I'm Magnus.
Today we're going to be looking at your army, Magnus.
Yes, we're going to look at the Space Wolves. It's been a work in progress for me for a couple of years. I'm quite happy with how it turned out. So we're going to review the units and take a closer look.
Yeah, looks good.
Thank you.
Let's begin. So, the Space Wolves. Take us through your army a bit.
Yeah. We start to the left here. We have the Land Raider. It took quite some time to paint.
I can imagine.
It's a big model with a lot of edges. And you can see the edges are highlighted.
Yeah, you have a really, what should I say, crisp look on the old army.
Yeah. I decided to paint the Space Wolf kind of neat, you know, clean looking.
Yeah.
So the way I want to do that is I sprayed the model black, primed it black, and then I painted with a dark gray color and avoided all the gaps in, you know, like the cracks over the armor and stuff. And then I used the lighter gray to really get the edges.
Get them to pop.
Yeah, yeah. Get them to pop into, yeah. So the tank really, it looks like it's just out of the fabric, but...
It's neatly done.
Yeah.
Looks nice.
So, yeah, thank you. then we have the Predator, kind of the same. I've used the same painting technique on my whole army, except for the Fenrisian Wolves. The Predator, I just wanted to have... I just wanted to have a Predator in my army. I didn't want to have the last cannon upgrade. Because I wanted to be cheap and just stay behind and soak up a lot of firepower and just do some havoc.
Yeah, good plan.
Yeah. In front of them we have my three little rappers. I actually named them...
That's the Lone Wolves, right?
Yeah, the Lone Wolves. The Lone Wolves are remains of you know, a troop or a unit. That's the whole unit has been lost.
It's the sole survivor.
Yeah, the sole survivor of the unit has been going through a pretty harsh battle. So he's alone, and his goal is to achieve glory and death. It's only a goal.
What do you name them?
Yeah, we have a kind of we have some different names here. We have Gunner,
or AKA Snoop Wolf.
A little bad humor there, but kind of a theme of the Lone Wolf, so yeah. for me that is.
We have Olaf, aka Lil Payne.
So it's another rapper, which I thought was kind of fun. And the last one is Thor, aka One Pack. So yeah, that's my Lone Wolves.
Bad gang.
Yeah, you don't want to meet them in combat. You're gonna chop your head right off.
The wolves.
Yeah.
Something special about them.
Yeah. You probably noticed it's not the regular Fenrisian wolves. I actually used the Chaos Hounds from Fantasy and mounted on 40mm bases. The reason I did that was because I thought the models for Fenrisian Wolves from Games Workshop was a little lame. They were too skinny.
Yeah.
It was not actually the kind of beast look that I wanted to have in my Fenrisian Wolves. So I have to look for another kind of model.
Yeah, it's a good choice.
Yeah, thank you. I think it's turned out really great, except I didn't use the horns because... Oh. Yeah,
it doesn't fit in.
No, it doesn't fit in because they're not corrupted or anything. It's like it's wolves.
Yeah.
So, Grey Hunters. I have quite a lot of them. I love Grey Hunters.
I can see.
Yeah. when I started with the Space Wolf, they had the rule True Grit, which allowed them to fire their bolter and use it in close combat. So it was kind of badass. But the rules changed and they had some upgrades, maybe, you can call it upgrades. They got a bolt pistol and a bolt gun and a close combat weapon. So to represent this, I have some models with the bolt, the bolter or and some with the bolt gun and chainsword.
Yeah.
Yeah, and there's some special weapons in there too. That applies to all my Grey Hunter units.
Yeah, so it has some mixed representation of what they have.
Yeah, and originally I wanted the Space Wolves to be a close combat army.
Yeah.
So with the True Grit I kind of got, you know, the shooting before I charged into combat, I can still hit hard. And it was a nice tactic. But then the rules changed, so and sadly I haven't come around to paint some blood claws yet, which is pure close combat unit for the Space Wolves.
So you have some characters here.
Yeah, I have four characters in my army. That's Wolfguard Battle Leader in the front with the Fenrisian Wolves. It's kind of a low cost character, just to, you know, when you have these small games and you just need to put in the character.
Cheap HQ,
just to get a character in there. So I made him. And then we have, I don't know how it's in English, Canis?
Canis is what we usually say.
Canis? Canis Wolfborn. Is the one in the middle there. I never actually used him more than once. Ever.
Expensive?
Yeah, it's expensive and
it's a cool model though.
Yeah, thank you. I used a lot of time on to paint it, but actually the one battle I used it was against Simon. And he killed me in the first round, so I never used it again. Which is kind of sad because...
Let's give an evil look to Simon behind the camera.
Yeah, a little evil look to Simon. But I'm planning to get to use him more. Maybe I use him as a Wolf Lord instead of Canis. But I will see what I will do eventually. Use him. I don't think Canis is a great character anyways. But it's an awesome model.
Looks cool.
Yeah, the model is cool. So, and we have my main HQ for my army. It's this fellow over here. I actually named him Morg Stormbringer. That's his name. He's a Wolf Lord in Terminator armor. It's Storm Shield and Thunder Hammer. So he's quite. He gives quite a punch, and he can sustain a great hit. So, with three wounds, four attacks. With that kind of armor and relentless, it's a great
character. Breaks the front lines.
Yeah, in a big game like 1500 points or so, it's a great character to have to just hold the line and break through. So
that's when I have that Death Star unit.
Yeah. I don't actually have any Terminators. I should probably get some of those.
Someone to accompany him into the front lines.
Yeah, but. What I've done when I played games with him is I have put him with Grey Hunters, and we put him into the Land Raider. So just rushed the Land Raider forward, straight up middle of the field, and deployed with assault. Since it is assault vehicle, all the models just come out and wreak havoc. It's kind of awesome.
I think you used that against me, versus my Dark Eldar.
Yeah, that's right. You felt the pain of the wolf.
Painful memory.
Yeah. Yeah, that's kind of a bad unit, but it's high cost, so you have to, you know, the rest of your army can't be...
It's a Death Star unit.
Yeah, it's a Death Star unit. You have to use it like that. So, we have some long fangs. Six of them, one leader, and five...
That's where the split fire...
Yeah, because, before it was like the leader gave them Spitfire, but now they have the Spitfire rule in the unit. So even if he dies, they have Spitfire. So that's kind of great. I usually just put him in front so he dies first. It's an extra wound. So I save my missile launchers.
Yeah.
A lot of strategy. Yeah. It's cannon fodder. I see a lot of armies online which uses
three of them or something.
Yeah, like it's three units.
Cheesy.
Yeah, it's kind of cheesy, but they're good.
Yeah,
it's a really good unit. So If you like cheese, go with it, but...
I think you're the only one that uses only one unit of those.
I think this is the first time I've ever seen just using one unit of long fangs above 1,000 points. But it's a really good unit, so it's not strange that people have a lot of them in their list.
But it is cheesy.
Yeah, it's real cheesy. So you just put all the spare Grey Hunters over here with lots of different weapons. And we have two Rhinos, one accompanying each squad. The one Razorback actually belongs to the Long Fangs. I use it as a backup support unit. So that's that. I don't have the third Rhino yet. I haven't made it for the third squad.
No. I can see I have some cool objective markers too.
Yeah, that was
some rune stones.
That was actually your idea.
And my clay.
Yeah, it was your clay. It was your idea to make this.
But it's your sculpting. It came out nice.
Yeah, thank you. I'm really satisfied with the results. It was kind of a last minute how to get an extra point in the.
It was the night before the Norwegian Championship.
Yeah.
That we hosted.
Yeah.
We were working
we were working all night to get it done.
I remember that. My hand is still shaking.
Yeah. But I think it turned out nice. I'm really happy with my army. So
you should be. It's a great army.
Thank you. In the future I will add some more units to it, but right now I'm satisfied. I have other projects.
Yeah.
So
yeah, I think that sums it up.
Yeah.
So, thank you for watching. This was Magnus' first appearance. He's also a member of Gryphon. Thank you for taking the time and coming in here.
It was my pleasure. If you'd like to see more awesome videos, please subscribe to our channel and visit our website.
Yeah, we have a link in the description below. And if you have any video requests, please leave a comment and we will have a look at it. So once again, I'm Jim.
And I'm Magnus.
See you soon.